Hello everyone, my name is Anastasios Papagiannis and I'm going to present our work with title Optimizing Memory Mapped I.O. for Fast Storage Devices. This is a joint work with Georgios Xanthakis, Georgios Alustos, Manolis Marzakis and Angelos Bilas, who is also my PhD advisor. Today, fast storage devices are a synonym to flash technology and in many cases with the NVMe protocol. They are capable of millions of I.O. operations per second and less than 10 microsecond access latency. Additionally, due to the different device characteristics, small random accesses are not such a big issue as in rotational disks. On the other hand, they require a large number of outstanding IOs in order to achieve peak device throughput. The common way to access persistent data is to use read-write system calls and the DRAM cache in order to reduce the number of accesses to the device. A kernel space cache, as we see in this figure, requires system calls for hits and contains raw serialized device blocks. A user space cache requires cache lookups in the case of hits and system calls only for misses. It is generally used to store application-specific deserialized data. Although a user space cache removes system calls in the case of hits, it still requires software cache lookups in the common path and this introduces overheads. An alternative way to access persistent data is to use memory mapped I.O. and in Linux this is a synonym to mmap. In memory mapped I.O., hits are handled entirely in hardware through the memory management unit and the TLB. In the case of a TLB miss, an additional page table walk is also required. As hits are handled entirely in hardware, this provides less overheads compared to software cache lookups. In memory mapped I.O., a file load device is mapped to a process virtual address space. Applications can use process or load store instructions in order to access data. In this case, the kernel is responsible to fetch and evict pages on demand. Memory mapped I.O. can provide more optimizations as it can remove the serialization and deserialization cost in the common path. This is possible as an application can access its data with load store instructions, and this enables the use of the same format for both in-memory persistent data. Additionally, in some cases, it can also remove memory copies between user and kernel space. However, misses in memory mapped I.O. require page fault instead of a system call which can introduce overheads. With memory mapped I.O., the 4 kilobyte page size introduces random I.O. operations in the common path. On the other hand, with fast storage devices, this is not a big issue. More importantly, Linux memory mapped I.O. path failed to scale with increasing the number of threads. We use a micro benchmark where each thread issues a load or store instruction at a randomly generated offset in the mmap area. These instructions result in random page faults. We use an LBLK device in order to observe the limits in the memory mapped I.O. path. This device uses the whole I.O. stack, but it does not issue the I.O.s to a real device. We use a 4TB dataset and 192GB of DRAM cache. X-axis shows the number of threads in 32-core server, and y-axis shows the million of page faults per second. As each page fault is 4 kilobyte in size, this is a synonym to IOPS. The blue line shows the case of reads when the user issues a load instruction, and the orange line shows the case of writes where the user issues a store instruction. In both cases, we observe that Linux memory mapped IO path failed to scale beyond 8 threads. In the case of 8 threads, it achieves 2 million IOPS. In the case of 32 threads, that achieves 1.3 million IOPS. Today, there are devices that are capable for more IOPS in the market. Fast storage requires a large number of outstanding IOs to achieve peak device throughput. In the case of 32 threads, we measure that the average queue depth is about 27. This is less than 32, which is the ideal in this case. In this paper, we propose FastMap, a novel memory mapped IO path that achieves high scalability and IO concurrency. FastMap is implemented entirely inside the Linux kernel. It avoids all centralized contention points, reduces the CPU processing in the common path, and uses dedicated data structures to minimize interference among processes. In this figure, we see the previous experiment, and we also provide the scalability curves for FastMap. In both read and write cases, it scales well up to 32 threads. It achieves 3 times more read IOPS and 6 times more write IOPS. FastMap is based on 3 main techniques. First, it separates data structures that keep clean and dirty pages to avoid all centralized contention points. Secondly, it optimizes reverse mapping to reduce CPU processing in the common path. And thirdly, it uses scalable DRAM cards to minimize interference among processes, which results in reduced latency variability. To conclude, FastMap is an optimized memory mapped IO path in the Linux kernel. It is scalable with a number of threads and incurs low CPU overhead. FastMap has significant benefits for data-intensive applications that use memory mapped IO to interact with fast storage devices on multiple servers. FastMap provides up to 11.8 times more IOPS with 30 cores and an LBLK device. With an Intel Optane SSD, it achieves up to 5.2 more IOPS with 32 cores. Thank you for your attention. I would like to answer your questions now, or you can reach me via email.